Hi, and welcome back to our open stop-motion film project. As you can see, I have not gotten farther with this than I was yesterday. And the day I have spent on trying to make the printer make the print as I wanted to, and those of you who have seen this before knew that the print was very hairy. Hairy like in this hairy. And I hope and think I have fixed it now, May. But you can see in the first part of the print is reasonably good, but the next part start to get really hairy. But the one I have just started from an hour ago, until now it looks very good. So hope I have, but you have to take the machine all apart and cleaned up. The extruder, it was a problem, and the extruder and the temperature and so on. It's a little fiddly thing to figure out how to. But we will carry on with this one because we need some new trees to print, and before we can do that, we need to scan them and mark them. So we will need to do a little work on them before that is gonna happen. I hoped I could do it today, but on the other hand, the print was very important for me to get right, because you have, if it don't print nice, then you have to make a lot of work to the prints afterwards, and then that take time, and there are enough to do, so we don't need the printer to make jobs for me. There are enough jobs anyway, so but the printer is kind of as I have said over and over again, it's not a kitchen appliance. It is really these printers are really a first generation of something that's gonna be even greater over time. But they are great, but you cannot do that with any of them. Don't let you fool of all their selling talks. All of them have these different problems, like they clog the extruder, and a lot of things can go wrong. You can just look at on the net, and there you can see how many kind of funny errors people have had with them. But that don't mean that they are good, and they are fun, but you have to realize you need to learn them to know very well before. You can get good print out of them. And maybe today I have fine print and I have that a week or a month or two, and then someday it starts to do something I haven't reckoned with. So I have I have nearly printed I have put 1.4 kilometers plastic through the extruder, so you can it has printed 24/7 for nearly a year now, so you can guess how many hours that is. And sometimes it goes months without any problems, and then suddenly for a week or a month ago it started to act up, and I couldn't figure out what was wrong, because it was not clogged or there was nothing, the plastic ran through the extruder, but I had to turn up the temperature and turn up the temperature, and I kept on turn up the temperature to I maxed out and couldn't understand that, because I have a infrared so I can measure the temperature, but when you measure the temperature with the infrared probe, then you thermometer, then you measure the external heat on the extruder. So, and the extruder was not clogged up, so I was pretty sure that it must be the plastic. There was something wrong with, so I bought new, more expensive plastic, but that didn't help. So then I figured out that must be something wrong with the extruder, that the inside temperature in the tube that heat up the plastic wasn't the same as the outside, so the temperature didn't reach the plastic. And then I took it apart. I could see that inside the tube there was over time a lot of, what shall we say, burned debris from the plastic inside the tube, like when you in a stove fire with wet wood or something, then you get kind of you get a chimney fire at last, but it kind of there comes some what shall we call it? I have gone lack of word now. The inner surface of the chimney gets what is the word? But here there is laying a lot of stuff on the inner surface, so. And that was what was wrong with the extruder, the tube inside that. It was kind of insulating the heat from the plastic. So, but the problem with that is that that's not a very big hole, so it's difficult to get something inside there to clean that up. I don't know of any solvent that can kind of resolve that, so it was a little tricky to get it out, but I got it out. And but then after that, it has to be pretty airtight, because when it moved from one piece of when it print here and then move over there, then it's extract the plastic in the extruder. So because otherwise you will just drag a thread from here to there, and kind of what we do here with this thread. And but and that's the cause of that is that here it's both that it's too hot, but also that it's the extruder are not airtight when it drag it back. So if there get any false air in, then we have a problem too. So it's a little tricky. So I took it apart today and tried to do a better job than I did the first time. And maybe, and I'm very excited if that's the case, maybe I'm lucky this time. But you're kind of always adjusting it. You can have a lot of problems with plastic, but the plastic I bought this time was a brand where I have a known melting temperature. The plastic I bought before, I didn't know anything about the melting temperature, so then it's a little hard to figure out if the temperature is right or not, if I don't know it. So and then of course there's always all kind of advice. People who have experience with the stuff, but they have one kind of printer and I have another kind of printer and so on, so it's not always. And they never have the exact same thing as I am, errors as I have, so you have kind of be guessing a little. But that was the same thing with the first computers we had. They also have their own personality. They were very tricky sometimes. Spend often more time get them running than computing anything with it. But most of them ended up being really sophisticated and good, and I guess that's how it will go with printers too. because the princess is actually no more than this. This is a dugong, and heat and plastic down to it, and then it runs around and lay the layer one at a time. And those of you who use glue guns know that they can also clog up very easily, depending on this is a light colored glue, so the temperature is low, with a low temperature, but you can get some with a higher, darker colored glue that have a higher melting temperature and so on. And that's how it is with the colors in the kind of in the printer too. Why, I don't know, but one color have one melting temperature and another color have another one, so it's not that straight as one would think. But the reason I bought the printer I bought was, first of all, this it could take. That's the printer that, of course, desktop printer, or what we shall call them, cheap printers that can take the biggest object. And at least at that time, I have not seen anyone since either. But maybe there is, I don't know. But at that time, it was the one who could take the big stuff yet. And of course, I love this home-built look it has, kind of. I'm from the generation where we had. My room was full of popular mechanics when I was a child, so I love that kind of stuff. And then I could buy it in a kit, so because I wondered if I could build it myself, I maybe better would be better to understand how it worked and functioned. And I think always that's a good thing if it's possible for you to do. And I think they are very kind of simple, so electronics also, so I was not afraid of it, and it was fun to build, really fun to build. But I think most people will be able to do it, and then they know how it works, kind of. I guess years from now we can buy some. They are much more fancy that can make color print and whatnot with a lot of small extruders or whatnot. I don't know how we can do. But I will guess that it will end up with that. Like our usually paper printers, but inkjet printers or whatnot. I'm sure they will figure out something. Yes. This is too far off, I think. trial and error. If a scientist found this tree, he would scratch his head a little and start celebrating because he had found a whole new species among trees. Think there's anything like it in the wild. But who knows? I'm afraid it's only in my imagination. Thank you. What's wrong with that? Send it in top. No. One good thing about working in this, it's not just prepared for 3D, it is 3D. Both 3D and interactive. That must be ideal. And by the way, we got the last episode of Kit's workshop with the last episode of the catapult. So if there's anyone that haven't seen those yet, is that we were building a catapult. Fun. we were building in it in cheap materials and with a very few tubes, cheap tubes. So most can participate. We do that every Monday from 6 p.m. my time to 7 p.m. Kind of meant to be a little, some of them a little parents' kit project. But those little older kids can do it themselves, but the smaller ones need a little help from the parents. I hope there's other than me there that think it's fun. But we have just started, so we'll see how it goes over time. Or if it's just me who think that could be a fun project. Very well can be Next time we are making on Monday we start to make a Minecraft wood. See how this that goes. Really want this. I want the kids to make me what they would think that would be fun to make, what they would like to make. what I like too is that give them the ability to build things themselves and do things themselves. And not that I think that there's anything wrong with computer games and that kind of stuff. That's perfectly okay. And I know a lot of people are up in arms about that, but take it easy. When I was born in 49, that was the first year that Donald Duck come to my country. And all those cartoons we read then, all the parents were up in arms that now the whole world will go bad because of that. You will never learn anything. We will sit and read comical and cartoons all day. World would end as we knew it. But it didn't. Of course it didn't. But always when there's coming something new, there's great panic. Often because we don't quite understand it. So, that's not the angle I'm coming from with the, I want them to be able to build something, so, because, but I also think that's a good ability to have. One's toolbox have to be as big as possible. Not literally, but you know what I mean. The more we can, the more possibilities we have. It has to be fun, otherwise it's not worth doing. Yeah. always admired when I have seen pictures from very poor countries in Africa, for example, where kids don't have any toy stores and whatnot, and then you see a kid playing with the car he had made in Coke cans, or and a really, really beautiful done one I once saw. Incredible creative. But if he want a car, then he have to make one. Maybe his father or mother helped him, but that's really fascinating. So it would be really a shame if we lost that ability. Not so much because it's needed, but more because it's fun. Starting to sewing themselves, and that's not because it can pay off, because it's cheaper to buy something produced in a cheap way in Asia than it is to do it yourself, but they have a good time doing it. And they can create something that nobody else has, something that represent their personality. At least in our country, when you're in a little city like mine, if you go down to buy in the different toy clothes stores, then they all have the same, more or less. There's no difference. You have to go to a big city to find something different. and even there it can be very difficult. It is a good thing. So. I see a lot of people around in the little place where I live. That's really lost when it comes to working with tools, and that's a shame, because it's always it can always be very helpful to. Be able to do things yourself. But if you don't, if you haven't learned it from childhood, you will probably have difficulty to get time to do it later in life. When there's children and work and what not to. And I think most people would like to be able to do their own home improvement and in a way that it don't look bad at all. Something to be proud of. There are no people with more thumbs than two. All the others talk is utterly nonsense. It's only a question of know-how and learning it. Try and fail and try and fail until you get it. We often hear, yes, but you are so creative. I am not. That's BS. Because creativity also is a learning process. Every kid knows are creative. Creativity is when the kids want to have something and they know the who of the parents are willing to do it, so they go and ask that parents. They don't ask the other one because they know they will get in that particularly situation. They know that he will say no and she will say yes, or the other way around. So depending on what they are asking, they go to the right parents. They very fast figure that out. That's creativity. Everyone has it. But if you let others tell you, or you tell yourself, I'm not creative, or, yeah, then you probably aren't, because you are shutting yourself out, or you don't allow yourself to make all the failures that others do. Oops. Keep on trying and you will succeed sooner or later. Whatever you do, you have to give yourself the time to do it. Seen a lot of, especially girls, that while they are small and young, they really like to draw and stuff like that. But then when they get a little older, then they start self-critiquing, and then we have a, because then they see others be good at something, who have more training than they have, and then they stop being because they think I'll never be that good, or I'm not good enough, or whatever. And that's a shame. Really shame. Boys often go another route, but it's the same with boys too. No difference. And always nice people around you, they are willing to tell you that you stink at it. And there are two ways to react on that. The one way is to get really depressed and stop doing it, or get Mr. Opposite and then really start doing it because they don't have to. They are not gonna tell you what to do, but that's a good thing. But a lot of people get saddened and think maybe they are right, and then they stop. The most reason for people to say that is when they tell you that you stink, then they themselves think they don't. And it's not always because they are evil or something like that. I don't think they think about it. And then there is another reason, and maybe apparent reason, and that is that sometimes if parents themselves, one of the parents themselves, have gone through some, what are we calling, defeat, or had some bad experience with something, then they don't want you to have the same experience. And so that may be worse when you were young, if they said things like that. I have always been told I was not good at anything, so, but I react like the first example I told, that they are not going to decide that, so I guess become Mr. Opposite. And now I'm so old that I don't care anymore what they do say. I do what I love regardless. So do you have something in your heart you always wanted to, or stomach, then do it. If you see others trying to tell your children or whoever, then encourage them. Whatever they fancy. Remember to tell them that it will be hard, because there are no easy way. My generation told our children that they could become anything, and one day my son told me that. But we forgot to tell them how hard it was. And that's right, that was a major mistake. But that was because we were so overwhelmed with the possibility. But we already knew that, regardless of the possibility, it was a hard job. If we would achieve something. Because in our head, of course, it would be hard. But the possibilities was there, so that was kind of a fantastic thing we thought. Shall we take a look? A little look. I will go over there because I cannot see any better than you can, and I cannot see any threat. Oh.
Until now, I only have a couple of threads. But I'll see how it goes. I'll take some new coffee. I took the temperature down to 200 degrees and now I'll see if that helps a little. I would love if I could fix that problem. But we will keep on adjusting until we reach the place where it works. I'll go over there in 10 minutes or so and see if it goes. But you know, if you go down under a certain temperature, not much under 200, then you start to clot the extruder, and no plastic will get out, and then the whole print is destroyed. So I have to be a little I need something I can do that with. But I don't have I need to see if I can get some really hot thread. Because when you go in to places like in behind there, I want to be able to and you cannot bend the needle because then it kind of break. Of course, that's a little too hard, but I don't know what, but if the printer is fixed, and I will try to work on that tomorrow. See if out something. Because it's a little hard to get in there behind the seat. Thank you. to keep an eye on it. Now that we have lowered the temperature. I don't think that one is on. I'll go and see. I don't know if it helped or not. There is more threat than I thought, but hope it will stop. But I hadn't put this one on, so I couldn't follow the temperature. You can see the temperature down in the lower part of the picture. See, now it's the extruder is down to 199.4. And then up again on 200. Just it keeps, it's around to 200, and I think we are golden. And it does. But I don't know if it helps. I cannot see any threat here, but wait a bit and then see. If it helped or not, who knows? Who knows how it goes? Tomorrow I can try with another plastic and see if that do the same thing. Later tonight, I probably will. And the print they are on. If it don't stop, if it stop, then it's okay. I think I will go and borrow my granddaughter's fine small fingers. But she will probably not lend them to me. Get a fine nail polishing disturbed. Then that will not be a bubbler. Grandfather anymore. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
this for anything. It's still printing. I'll go and take a look again. I don't know if I can get rid of those threads. But it's not as much as it was before, but I'm not totally understand, I think. Maybe someday I will. but I will not stop before it's fixed. Because I hate it. I won't have it. Has to figure out how I can get rid of it. Behind. This don't. this. Thank you. I think we need something else. I'll go and take some toothpicks. You must admit you need to have a lot of different stuff when you do things like this. Toothpaste, everything. I have sand from a beach, and I have sawdust, and I have wires and sticks. And ribbons and tons and tons and tons of crazy stuff. That's one thing when I, because the studio is kind of too small. But my God, if I have to move to a bigger place, that will be a crazy job because of all the stuff I have. What do I do? I do this. Keep saving stuff like a hoarder when you get something that others would throughout, then I look at it and then I think maybe I can use that for something sometime. Sometimes you have to be hard and throw stuff out. then a week after that, you need exactly what you threw out. So okay, need to do something like this. But most stuff get used. And even some of it we need to get more and more up. Do we do that? Maybe we do that. Okay, we don't. Yes. Okay, what have you done? This one. Kind of starting to be a little soft. down here. When you roll it, you transfer a lot of heat to it. This one. Thank you.
nose are still in the prints, so that's one good thing. This is gonna be a crazy scan, I'm afraid.
It would be nice with some more light in the box. I should have bought two of the light in the back, so I had in the, one in the front too. But I thought one was enough. It kind of is, but it's a little dark in there. Maybe we'll put one more in at some point. But I had to get one more monitor, so I have one in yellow room in the workshop. I needed them, the one I have don't work in there because it's a VGA, and even if I put a transformer on it, it don't work, it won't see it. So I would put an HDMI in there. Then you'll see if that helps. Still have a little issue in there. I was thinking of bending one of those, but I'm afraid they will break.
I have to. Maybe I have. I will try something. Bend one of these spike. If I can, this fingers. Cut it. Yes. And we will try, see how that. That's difficult to hold. I think that's doing the set same as the cover does. So it need to be a flat piece. That one cannot get in there. I have to visit the bathrooms and we'll see. And then I will visit that one there too. Thank you. I do not get any more threads. That's nice. And that will mean that the next time, the next print will be totally without. If the theory is good. Big. Thank you. How do I do that?
Someone tells you that you are just thumbs, then you can tell them that thumb is actually a really good tool.
Okay, I need a paper towel. You should run over that.
Thank you.
this I had. Maybe I don't have any more. I don't know if you even can see it. You can't. But it's very bright, very, very bright light we have on the side here. Oh, in this side, you can see on my hand. And it's not this one, but up there, a big softbox. But it actually went better when this light went a little up. Yeah. At least that's how it looks on my monitor. No, it's a little overdone, but if anything, shall be left and seen in print, then it has to be a little overdone. Of course, most of it will disappear. In both scan and print. But I hope a little bit. Hopefully.
guy, our friend Vincent, Van Gogh. I like this tree. Of course, it's kind of, it's yellow and kind of how he would paint one. You both like the color and I guess. But I will not cut near. And now the print is finished. Except we, that was very much like called for. See, there's thread here, but after I adjusted the temperature, there are not many. So, comparison to this one. So, that's a good thing. So, something I managed to do right. Still a little on the top here, but the last bit of it, there was no thread at all. So that's very, very good. And these are easy to remove. So we are happy with that, and on that note, we will stop for today, tonight, because once again we have reached midnight here in my little corner of the world, and we will go on replay, and then I'll hope I'll see you again tomorrow. So, good night and thank you for viewing. Hi.